Hi folks, somebody on YouTube has asked me if I could do a video on how to clean up a Mamod TE1A that he's had sitting unused for quite a while. It's not the sort of thing that I usually do videos on, but I thought it might be useful for a few people, so I thought, why not? I don't have a TE1A, but I do have a TE1, which is similar in many respects. There's just some minor differences in the engine side, and also it's got a water level plug instead of a level sight glass window, and differences in the burner and things like that. But basically it's the same model. Now I'm going to limit myself to that specific scenario as requested. In other words, an engine has been sitting on a shelf or in a cupboard, unused for a while, and is getting a bit grubby and maybe got some old oil gummed up and things like that. I'm not going to do a complete strip down and rebuild or anything like that. This is a fairly routine sort of cleanup session. However, I don't expect anybody to do this every time they run an engine. This is just to get an engine back into working condition that hasn't been used for a while. One of the questions often asked is, what do you use for cleaning? There's no simple answer to that. It varies. Meths is a good solvent for use on bare metal, brass, steel, aluminium, whatever. But it's not really a good idea on paintwork because it can damage the paint surface. Safest thing for paint is warm soapy water. Warm water with a few drops of washing up liquid in. That's what I've got here. Now I said I'm not going to do a complete strip down rebuild, but obviously you need to dismantle it to a certain extent. Things like the scuttle and burner just lift out and the burner pulls out from the scuttle. This is a TE1, an older version, so it has a METS burner. The TE1A probably has an Esbit style burner, but same principle. Also the canopy, it normally hinges back like that for when you're using it, but it will also unclip completely like that. Next you should remove things like the safety valve, the water level plug in the case of a TE1. The TE1A doesn't have a water level plug, it has a plastic window instead. The whistle, if it comes off easily, remove that. Sometimes you find that if it's been sitting around for a long time, that won't come off. Don't force it. If it doesn't come off, leave it in place. Doesn't matter. Put all these bits in a plastic tub. Next you have to remove the cylinder. Now in some of the very early ones there's just a nut holding the spring on the trunnion bolt, and that can be undone by hand. But certainly the TE1A, and in this case the later TE1s, it has a bolt screwed directly into the cylinder. And you can't do that by hand, so you need some sort of a 6BA spanner, or if you haven't got a 6BA spanner, adjustables or pliers or whatever. But I have here a 6BA box spanner. Now, make sure you don't lose the bolt or the spring or the nut in the case if you've got a nut. Put those in the plastic thing and the cylinder just lifts off like that. And the piston just pulls out. Put those in the plastic tub and anything else which comes off easily, like the drive band, sometimes that gets greasy, so it's a good idea to clean that as well. Put that in your tub as well. And then all those parts are metal, so it's quite safe to use meths. Now, I've got here this plastic bottle of used meths. So I'll just pour some of that into the tub, just to cover all the parts. And put that aside. Leave it overnight. Leave it as long as you like, while you concentrate on the rest of it. Okay, so when you take the cylinder off, you see the you've exposed the port face there. That's usually covered in greasy, horrible stuff. So again, it's bare metal, so meths is safe. Just clean that off. And make sure the two port holes, or in the case of a TE1A, the three port holes, are clear. So then start on the paperwork. You might as well start at the top with the canopy. Be careful with the transfers, one on either side and on either edge. They tend to be very fragile after a few years, so don't rub those too hard. But the paintwork, you can rub quite hard, with as long as you use something safe like soapy water. So take your rag, dip it in the soapy water, and just rub over quite vigorously. Most of the dirt will come off quite easily. As I said, avoiding the transfers on the edge. Now, you usually find that the paint is a little bit scorched, even if it's not covered in soot. There isn't much you can do about that unless you're going to repaint it. Or you can maybe use something like T-cut or even metal polish to remove the top layer of paint if you're that fussy. Okay, so repeat that process on everything that you want to clean, like of the firebox here. Again, any transfers, be very careful. Just a very light rub, maybe. Now the chrome, if that's in good condition, then you might be able to clean that up. But usually you'll need to use some sort of metal polish for that. Obviously if it's crumbling, flaking off, there isn't much you can do about that. Either leave it as it is, or paint it, or buy a new one. Most of the paintwork usually comes up with your soapy water. And I'm not going to do all of this, but you've got the idea. The bit at the front of the smoke box here, sometimes that can get a bit grubby, and just wiping it over doesn't get inside the interstices. So this is where something like an old toothbrush, or this is a plastic bristled brush, dip that in your soapy water and clean out the interstices like that. That should come up nicely. It's also helpful, this brush is also helpful for the wheels, around the spokes of the wheels. Just do that around all four wheels. Now the Metz burner, or the Esbit burner, by definition, that should be safe with meths. So dip your cloth in the meths and rub over that. Make sure that the mesh in the top of the burner, if it's a meths one, is clear, all the holes are clear. Now you may find there's some rust on here. Normally I would leave that, but if you're really fussy, you can repaint it, but using high temperature paint. If there's any rust on any of the other steel parts, like the firebox, it's a good idea to treat that with some rust remover. Quite often the area around the water level plug, in the case of a TE1, sometimes that gets a bit rusty, and if it's not treated, rust will only get worse. So either repaint it or just treat it with rust remover and some sort of varnish or something to protect it. Okay, now we've got everything, I'll assume that you've got everything as clean as you want it. Now the time is to get everything in working, good working condition. Now the crankshaft should spin quite easily like that. If it's anything like sticky, then you need to, it's probably some old grease inside the bearings. Really, perhaps some WD-40 in there, or a little bit of meths. Be careful you don't use too much of it. Don't rub it on the paintwork. But some sort of solvent will get rid of any old grease in there. Now, when you come back tomorrow or whenever, having left the metal parts to soak in meths, you then take these out one at a time. And we have the cylinder there. So we take the piston out as well. Now they should be fairly oil free now. Just test the piston in the cylinder. It should be very smooth and free. Any rough spots, then you need to get rid of those. It may be gummed up oil, in which case just lots of meths, keep on working that in and out with the meths. If it's oil, that'll clean that. If it's corrosion, then you'll need to go a bit further, get some emery cloth, very fine emery cloth, nothing rough, roll it up or roll it around a pencil or something like that, and work that up and down inside the cylinder. And the same with around the surface of the piston if that's corroded. And when you're finished, that should be very free and easy. Do that with any of the other parts that you've got in there. The whistle. Anything which... Now this whistle looks a bit grotty. It'll probably work. But... you might want to brighten it up a bit. Let's get a brass brush. Now these are quite often sold in car, Halfords, places like that, car parts places, for cleaning up spark plugs. They're ideal for cleaning up brass parts as well. So just brush that, clean all the grot off it. Make sure that the lever works freely. Now in the TE1A, that's got a spring-loaded lever. Make sure that works and make sure the plunger goes in and out easily. Now, on the bottom of the whistle, and also the safety valve, there's a little fibre washer. If that's still on there, just make sure that it's intact. It may come off into the mess. If that's breaking up, replace it. They're 10 a penny. In fact, I quite often make my own using PTFE sheet and punching them out using hole punches. But they're cheap enough to buy. So buy them. Yeah, certainly if you've got lots of models, then buy them by the hundred. Yeah. The water level plug, the same, that's got its little washer, and again if you want to brighten it up a bit, use the brass brush, or alternatively you can use metal polish for these, for brightening things up. Make sure you don't lose the little spring from the trunnion and the trunnion bolt or nut, as the case may be. Now the safety valve actually has two washers. There's one on the main thread there, like the other parts, but there's also one underneath the plunger. Now that quite often is deteriorated, or it may be even missing. Now I can see in this case it's beginning to deteriorate a bit. If you push the plunger from the bottom, you can usually see that if that needs replacing. In this case it does. In fact, it's just completely breaking up. So that needs to be replaced if necessary. In this case it certainly does. Now you can either use a small O-ring, as you can find in the plumbing department of your DIY store, or all the usual toy steam suppliers supply little O-rings. Or alternatively, you can cut the slice off a thin plastic bit of tubing. Anything that's rubbery and about the right size will do. Now I've rummaged in my stock of washers and O-rings and found the right size of O-ring, also a new fibre washer. The other one was getting a bit tatty. I've also dug out the tool, special tool for working with Mamod safety valves. To use this, unscrew this part and you screw in the valve into the other end, to the large end. And then screw this part back in slowly, and it'll push out the plunger and it'll hold it there, so you can then work on it at ease. If you don't have a tool, don't worry, you can do it as long as you've got three hands and ten fingers on each hand. With a little bit of patience you can do it. It just means that you need to hold the plunger open while you're working. Use a screwdriver or whatever's handy to remove the old O-ring, the old seal, like that. And then get your brass brush, dip it in the meths, and just remove all the remains of the old O-ring. Like that. Then once you've got the old O-ring out, you then need to stretch the new one over. Now it'll look as if it's far too small, but you'll be surprised at how far they'll stretch. But you can't do it by hand, so you need something tapered. I got the end of an old ballpoint pen here, so you push the O-ring up onto that. And then it'll slip easily over onto the safety valve plunger. As easy as that. And then just remove the tool, and you have a brand new seal in your plunger. These little tools, by the way, are worth their weight in gold. They're made of brass, not gold, but they're worth, it'd be worth it if they were made of gold. As you've just seen, it makes the job of replacing those little washers O-rings. Such an easy job. They come in two sizes, one for the quarter inch safety valve, like this one. There's also a larger size for the 3/8 inch ones. Now the quarter inch safety valves come in two lengths, a long and a short, which is why you need this separate screw-in bit. The larger, the 3/8 inch size, doesn't have that. You just screw in the safety valve, and just the action of screwing it in raises the plunger. The tapered bit, unfortunately, doesn't come with it. As I said, just cut the end off an old biro or whatever. Anything that's tapered. Now, when you've got everything as clean as you want it, don't throw away your dirty mess. Keep it like I do. Pour it back into the bottle. Don't be tempted to put it in your burner and burn it, because it may not work very well, and it'll certainly create a hell of a lot of smoke. But certainly use it again for cleaning purposes. So there's a point where you start reassembling it. You've got the safety valve, which we've just replaced the seal on. Put the new washer on the thread. Screw that back into the hole. Same with the whistle. The washer appears to be okay in this one, but again, replace it if necessary. Screw that back. Water level plug, again check the washer, replace if necessary, screw that in. The cylinder. Now, we already checked that this works freely and the hole's clear. Make sure the holes here are clear. Comes the tricky bit of putting the trunnion screw back on. So you put the spring on the bolt. Put the piston big end back onto the crank, and line up the cylinder with the hole. Now, in the case of the TE1A, you'll also have the reversing lever. So you put the trunnion bolt through the reversing lever first, and then in through the port face and through into the cylinder. You have to try and screw that in without letting it go, otherwise you lose it. Screw it in finger tight, and then just nip it up with the spanner, 6PA spanner. Not too tight, you don't want to strip the thread, but you don't want it to come flying off when you're using it. Canopy clips back into its mounting, front end. The front end, in this case, just clips on. Some models have a screw on, which you tighten up to hold it, or untighten it to lift it up. This one's just got a spring clip. The band, drive band, goes over the pulley on the flywheel, and then round the wheel. The burner slots back into the scuttle, which then hooks onto the back of the engine. And there you have a cleaned and hopefully in working condition traction engine. Next stage is it's the fun bit to try it out. Okay, I hope you've found that helpful, and I am for the guy who asked me to do it, can't remember his name now, something like Clipper Bus or something like that. I hope I've covered everything that you need to know. As I said, the next bit is the fun bit. Try it out and test it. You may find that it still needs a bit of problems, you know, a bit of fault finding. But if you've cleaned everything, cleaned out all the gummy stuff, it should work. Usual tips: fill the boiler with distilled or soft water, anyway, rainwater will do. Oil everything that works. Ideally, you should use proper steam oil in the cylinder, but any thick oil will do there, and on the port face. The other moving parts, ordinary 3-in-1 will do. Use the whatever fuel it was intended for. Obviously, for an old meths burner, use meths, or you can use bioethanol, which is basically the same stuff but without the purple dye. Don't be tempted to use other kinds of alcohol, especially things, you know, IPA, things like that. They don't work very well, and they smoke, and they may be dangerous. And definitely not paraffin, petrol, or anything like that. Stick to meths. That's what it's intended for. If you've got the more modern solid fuel burners, you can either use the proper tablets. I don't like them. A lot of people don't like them. They stink like hell. You can use a gel type fuel like Sterno in the solid fuel burners. If you use Sterno, it's a nice thick gel, so you can spoon that in and it won't run out, or even when it's burning it doesn't run. Some of the gel fuels are a bit runny, so you need to line the burner with aluminium foil or something like that. But if you use proper Sterno, it's thick enough, you can just spoon it in place of the solid fuel tablets. You can buy gas conversion for use with LPG. They tend to be a bit expensive, but if you've got several Mamod mobiles, it's worth buying one. They're so much better than the traditional fuels. That's about it. Good luck.